Hi, in this video I'm going to teach you how I edit my videos, how I do the whole split screen thing without duetting myself. The first thing you're going to need, the app CapCut or an editing app. My favourite one is CapCut and I'm going to show you how to do this on CapCut today. You're also going to have to be able to screen record. I'm going to go straight in and I'm going to show you how I edit my videos. First of all, I film the video on TikTok. I film it with the sound on TikTok and then I save the video to my draft. I actually end up saving a lot of videos to my drafts because I like to have options to see which one I prefer. But once that's done, I will go into my drafts and I will go through all the videos and I'll find the one I like best. So once I have screen recorded the TikTok video, go into my camera roll, crop it down to the right size. So I crop it down to 9x16. I will crop it to the parts of the video that I want to keep in and then I'll just save the video. Now that I've done that, it is ready to be put onto CapCut. So I'm going to go into the CapCut app, I'm going to open a new project and I'm going to only insert one of the videos that I've picked. On CapCut, it's really easy to alter the size of your video. So you literally just pinch and it zooms in and out. And then to add in the other video, I'm going to go onto this bit here, overlay, and I'm gonna add overlay and I'm gonna insert the other video. Now I can just adjust that video to size. Sometimes I like to play about with the sizes. I like the black line between the videos. Sometimes it's thicker, sometimes it's thinner. It's totally up to you what you want to do with that wee black line. So I put them next to each other and I listen out to the audio to make sure the audio syncs up on both videos. Okay, so that's it synced up perfectly. So you can probably see there's a bit of a difference in size. I'm a bit of a perfectionist, so I want both sides to be roughly the same size. And what I mean by that is the faces, like the size of my face in the video, I want them to be level and the same size. I play around with the clips. I might have to drag one of them down slightly. I might have to make the other side a little bit bigger. Whatever you want to do to fix this, you can. If you want to crop it, zoom it in, make the individual clip bigger, you go into the crop section and you can kind of do it that way. I'm only doing this ever so slightly. One other thing I find absolutely essential when making these videos is cleaning up my lines. Don't worry if when you put these videos in the lines are all up and down. You can literally see on my screen right now as I'm editing, the lines are, they're not synced up at all. I go into overlay again, I click add overlay. And I go into stock videos here and I just take the black screen and what I do is I fit that screen to size and I level off the lines so that like the video sizes are completely perfect. They're on par with each other. They're perfect. It's a straight line, you know. CapCut used to have it as a picture but now it's a video, so to extend that I just put the speed down to 0.1. You got two sides, so what you can do here is you can just copy that and add that to that side. And this also makes it easier when you're trying to level off the faces. Okay, so for me this is good enough, so I can move on to the next steps at this point. Just to clarify what we've done so far, we've screen recorded our videos, we've cropped them to size and we've uploaded them into CapCut. We've uploaded one main video, we've then added an overlay and we've cropped them to the size that we want, so that being the middle of the screen. It's up to you if you want that black line between the videos. You don't need the black line, it's completely up to you. We've now adjusted the videos so the faces are kind of on par with each other. We've also added in a black screen to level out these videos. And that's what we've done so far. The next step is adding the text. This is really simple and easy, but again, if you've not done this before, it might not be if you don't know where to look. At this point, what I like to do is I like to export this video and open another CapCut project. So I'm now going to take that file that I've just exported into my camera roll, open this new project and add the text to it. I just like to do this so I have multiple files to fall back on if something goes wrong. But this is a really simple video edit, so it's not as necessary. Anyway, one thing to keep in mind when you're editing these videos for like Reels and TikTok and Shorts, you need to take into consideration that side menu. You're going to want to set the video slightly higher. You do not want this in the middle of the screen because if you put your video in the middle of the screen, it's going to block your face with that sidebar menu. So You want to put it slightly up, just how I've done here. It's not in the middle. Now we get to add our text. To add your text, it's just on the main bar menu. As soon as you go into CapCut, you click on text, add text. Now this is up to you on how you want to design your text. There are multiple text options. I just go with the standard font usually. You can add whatever colors you want. I like to go pink and purple. Just follow the screen. You edit the text. While you're doing the text, of course you want to match it up with the audio. So CapCut, it just allows you to move the text along. So just listen out for the audio and drag it to where it fits best. Just play about with the text and see what you like best. It's a very deep rabbit hole to go down. Trust me, there are so many options and so many things you can do. This isn't sponsored. I just really love the app for editing social media videos and stuff like that. So yeah, I've just finished adding the text. At this point, really important to watch the video through, make sure everything is up to par, how you want it to be. And then you can save it. So I've watched it through, everything's good to go. So I'm just gonna export that to my camera roll and it's ready to be uploaded. I hope this was easy enough for you. Yeah, at this point, I take over to TikTok. This is how I upload it. I'll go over to the sounds in the drafts. I'll click on the sounds. I'll upload the video. So I'll adjust the volume so that the original sound is heard over the added sound, because the original sound is the sound you edited with and that's the one you kind of want to be heard. I put the added sound just down to like 1%. I've noticed with TikTok, if you put it down to 0%, it doesn't get added with the sound. So put it down to 1% and put the other one up to like 100%, which is halfway. Please do not put it up to 200%. It will like burn your ears. Once you export it, you will want to crop that. Just gonna split it. And yeah, then I do my usual description, so I'll do like POV and then I'll kind of explain what's going on. So this video is literally a carbon copy of another girl's video, but I loved her idea, so I wanted to try it out. So every time I do that, I will credit whoever came up with the idea first, because some people have just genius ideas and I see them, I'm like, oh, I wish I came up with that. That's it, ready to upload. You can select your cover. For me, I save it to drafts because I like to upload mine in my evening time. And that is that video ready to go, so yeah, hopefully that was simple enough for you to follow. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching and I hope this was somewhat helpful to you, and I will see you next time. Bye. Oh, that was such a cheesy ending. Do you want to see my dog? This is my dog. Her name is Winky. She's very precious.